on, God, this morning for you being here. Amen. We just thank you for his goodness and his mercy. It's just good to be in the land of the living. It's good to know Jesus. It is so good to know Jesus. Amen. And we're just so excited this morning. And we thank God for you coming in. And the people are here. And we thank God for the women of this church. We thank you for your obedience. And we just love you and just appreciate God in you this morning. So we thank God for you. And let's just get excited for Jesus. How many of you this week have not taken the time and just said to him, thank you, Lord. Lord, I thank you this morning. Thank you for your loving kindness. Thank you for your mercy. We just thank him this morning. He's a healer. He's a deliverer. He's all that we need. Everything we need is in Jesus. We find everything we need in Jesus. So we greet you this morning in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We're excited. Come on, let's get excited. I know those of you that have not fellowship with each other this morning, let's take the time this morning and just greet each other in brotherly and sisterly love in the name of Jesus. Just greet each other. Let's take this time because we've not greeted each other. Let's greet each other. Hallelujah. Glory to God this morning in the Most High God.
Bless you, brother. Lord. Bless you, too.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I was glad when they said it unto me.
Isaiah 6, down that first verse and a few of the following verses. In the year King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord. He was sitting on a lofty throne, and the train of his robe filled the temple. Curving around him were mighty seraphims, each with six wings. With two wings they covered their faces, with two they covered their feet, and with remaining two they flew. In a great chorus they sang, Holy,
yeah.
Is the Lord Almighty.
Yeah.
The whole earth is filled with his glory.
Yes.
The glorious singing shook the temple to its foundation, and the entire sanctuary was filled with smoke. My God. Then I said, my destruction is sealed, for I am a simple man and a member of a sinful race. Yet I have seen the King, the Lord Almighty. Then one of the seraphims flew over to the altar and picked up a burning coal with a pair of tongs. He touched my lips, with it and said, see, this coal has touched your lips. Now your guilt is removed and your sins are forgiven. Then I heard the Lord saying, whom should I send as a messenger to my people? Who would go for us? And I said, Lord, I'll go, send me. And he said, yes, go. But I tell my people, this you will hear my words, but you will not understand. You will see what I do, but you will not perceive this meaning. May God ever bless the reading of the
word. Amen. Well, thank you, Lord.
May we bow our heads in a word of prayer. We are in God's house.
Thank you.
We are God's people. We turn our heart and mind toward our Maker, who is our God, the Lord of all salvation. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. God, we just come. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for life. Thank you for the waking us up to this new day. New day, God. We never saw before. And God, we just praise you. God, we thank you, Lord, for all you've done for us. God, we thank you, Master. You are Lord, you are Savior, you are Deliverer, you are our healer. You are our protector. Lord. And God, we just thank you, Lord. You are our healer and our brother. God, we thank you, Father. Bring us over the danger in our way. Lord, and God, we just thank you. Thank you, God, and let healing be all over the building. Let your word come forth in power and healing and deliverance. And God, we thank you, man.
Nothing without you.
God, we can do nothing without you.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Come on, let's praise the Lord. Come on, give the Lord a hand of praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on, give the Lord a hand of praise. Hallelujah. How many know that the Lord is good? Hallelujah. How many know that the Lord is still blessing? Y'all gonna praise the Lord with me? Are y'all ready to praise the Lord with me? Hallelujah. Come on, give the Lord a hand of praise right now. worship the name of God. Praise the Lord, praise Him. Come on, praise Him. If you know that the Lord is good, go ahead and open your mouth and bless the Lord right now. Hallelujah. If you know that the Lord made a way for you, go ahead and praise Him. Hallelujah.
Good. I don't know what your praise is. I don't Bless each family. Lord, let us not give grudgingly, but give in love. Yes. Bless each one that have it to give. Yes. Bless those that desire to give but do not have it. We pray in your son Jesus' name. Amen. Yes. Would you please face the walls on each side and the left and start from the rear.
Amen.
To this, and they have three qualifications. They got to be 62 years of age, disabled, own their own home, and must meet the income guidelines for the program. And you can contact Brenda Johnson or Tracy Ross at 371-6825, and the deadline for this is May 16th. And the City of Little Rock, June the 28th through the 30th, this is a conference. This has to do with our youth intervention program, June the 28th through the 30th. And our regular announcements are the Men's Ministry meet every third Saturday at 7. Women's Joy Fellowship every fourth Friday at 7. Sunday evening service on the first and third Sunday at 6:30. Choir rehearsal Wednesday before the second Sunday and Wednesday before the fourth Sunday and every second Sunday. And our praise team rehearsal on the first and third Sunday. Wednesday night prayers at 6:30. Bible studies at 7 o'clock. Our Sunday morning prayer is at 9. And our Sunday school is at 9:30. And our morning worship is at 10:45. Thank you. These are our announcements.
Amen.
You're getting ready, the pastor is going to come, but you can be preparing.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm going to get out the way quickly, but I just want to make a quick acknowledgement before I forget it. Hallelujah. You know, we have a young lady among our midst that has been very supportive and very faithful in her attendance and support of this church. And but she had never made it official that she wanted to be a part of this church. Amen. So I approached her and talked with her briefly, and she acknowledged that she wants to make it official.
Amen.
To be a member of this church.
Amen. Amen.
And I thank God for her, and I thank God for Sister Cox. Sister Cox, will you stand just briefly so they'll know who you are? Amen. Just stand just briefly. Amen. Amen. So we'll know who you are. Many of you already know who she is, but she don't say anything. Praise God. And I understand and I appreciate that and I respect that.
Amen.
But I asked her, I said, I thank you for your support and your faithfulness.
Yes.
Amen. And supporting this ministry. I said, come on, let's make it official. Amen. And she has graciously submitted to that. And I want to acknowledge her and I'm sure my appreciation for her.
Yes.
As all of you, we thank God for you for making up this great Bread of Heaven family.
Amen.
Amen. We thank you and we give you praise. Amen. Now we're back in the hands.
Amen.
Yeah.
excited for our Lord because we're here to encourage each other. This is what Fifth Sunday is all about. Encouraging each other. Lifting each other up. Letting each other know you can do it. You can make it. Go a little further. You can make it a little further. You can go a little further. And this is why Pastor and I, we just said, there's got to be something that the ladies can do, not just once a year.
That's right.
Not just once a year. So we're excited for the fifth Sunday. Every fifth Sunday. We come forth and we just be excited for the Lord. We just don't pray coming up to the fifth Sunday. We pray all the other Sundays. But we really get excited on the fifth Sunday.
Lord,
amen. Before our speaker comes, Sister Tabitha is coming. And she's going to bless us with a poem that the Lord has given her. Let's say praise the Lord.
Worship, O God Most High, as I surrender from my heart a true and living sacrifice. Letting go of those ways that are not pleasing to you, preparing to worship in spirit and in truth. Inwardly consecrating everything that's not right, every way that sin brought to light. An instrument of holiness, my body I present, worshiping my Lord God with reverence unspent. Be pleased with my worship, O God Most High. For I surrender to you a true and living sacrifice.
All right. Amen. 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 Glory to God this morning. Hallelujah. Be pleased. Right. Be pleased. Be pleased. We want God to be pleased with everything we do, every breath we take, every step we take. We want God. Pleased, and we thank God for each and every one of you, Sister Tabitha. We thank God for you being a part of this ministry and just letting the Lord use you. That's what we are excited about. Letting the Lord use us. Hallelujah. We do have a guest, Caden. Is it Caden?
Tyranny.
Tyranny Ousley Johnson.
Amen.
We thank God for you being here. God bless you. For your support, and we pray that something has been said to continue to encourage you in the way of the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Now we're down to the meat. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I tell you, the Lord is so good to us. He continued to teach us how to walk in love through others with their ministry. When we walk in love, then we understand that God is in control. Then when we are faithful, He sent someone to encourage us. He sent someone with a word. Now, Sister Tanya, I met her years ago. And I kept telling Sister Tanya, I said, would you come over and speak for me on a Wednesday night? We do a 21-day fasting and prayer. And I encourage the friends to come out and speak, and she came forth and had a word and really blessed us. And so she continued to come and visit us and continued to come to prayer, come to Wednesday night service. And she looked at me and she said, you know I'm gonna join, don't you? And I said, well, I had it in my spirit, but I wasn't gonna say anything. I learned this from my grandmother. Encourage others
But don't plant anything in their spirit. Let the Lord speak to them.
Yeah.
Let the Lord speak to them. And then it won't be, they won't be confused and saying, somebody told me, you told me to join. The Lord told you to join. Or the Lord told you to say this. Or the Lord said, go here. Or the Lord said, encourage this person. My sister Patsy. So I was so excited. Pastor and I were so excited. And for her to come and to encourage us, encourage the body. So I'm going to ask you to stand as she come forward. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord.
Tell them. He said, tell them.
get the job done.
All right.
He said, get the job done. That's what he said. See, I got it first. I got the whooping first. I got it. He said, are you doing everything I told you to do? Are you sure? Are you praying like you're supposed to be praying? Are you fasting?
Yeah.
Oh, are you showing up for Sunday school on time?
Come on.
All right.
I'm talking to me.
Come on.
I'm talking to you. But he did tell me to tell you to get the job done. And he told me yesterday in prayer, in order for you to get the job done, you're going to have to enter in. See, that was the second part. I didn't know what he was talking about. But he began to mess with me all on the floor.
Uh-huh.
I couldn't shake anything off of me. I said, my God, what are you saying? He said, tell him I said, get the job done. But before you can get the job done, you're going to have to enter in.
Mm-hmm.
All
right. That's true.
Yeah.
That's what he said.
Uh-huh.
So he sent me over to Judges. And everyone, please turn to Judges, chapter 4. Oh, hallelujah. And have your way, God.
Have your way, Lord.
I'm going to straighten out my... I act like this is my little desk. Because I'm going to go like... I have it all together. Because Satan be trying to mess with your mind, try to tell you that the Lord didn't tell you to
come on,
say this or do this. He messed with you.
Jesus.
If you don't mind, please stand for the word. We're coming out of Judges 4, verse 4 through 9. And Deborah, a prophetess, the wife of Libni, she judged Israel at that time.
Mm-hmm.
And she dwelt under the palm tree of Deborah between Ramah and Bethel in Mount Ephraim. Mm-hmm. And the children of Israel came up to her for judgment. And she sent and called Barak the son of Abinoam out of Kadesh Naphtali and said unto him, has not the Lord God of Israel commanded, saying, go and draw toward Mount Tabor, and take with thee 10,000 men of the children of Naphtali and of the children of Zebulun. And I will draw unto thee to the river Kishon, Sephirah, the captain of Jabin's army, and his chariot and his multitude, and I will deliver him into thine hand. And Barak said unto her, if thou wilt go with me, then I will go. But if thou wilt not go with me, then I will not go. And she said, I surely go with thee. Notwithstanding, the journey that thou takest shall not be for thine honor. For the Lord shall sell Sisera into the hand of a woman. And Deborah arose and went with Barak to Kishon, Kadesh. Amen.
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 Amen. I want to talk to you about, you can have a seat. The book of Judges is one of those books that is a gritty book. It's a dirty book.
Right.
It's filled with sin.
Right.
Come on.
Violence and the judgment of God. This book contains qualities that might appeal to men more than women.
Oh, yeah.
The book of Judges is a book that actually elevates the position of a woman.
That's right.
Come on.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It elevates the position of a woman in Israelite society. In the chapters before us, we were introduced to a woman, Deborah. She was a great woman of God. God used her for his glory. But not only was Deborah in that story, Jael was in that story.
Come on.
So he used two. Not just one. He used two. One was a respected leader in the nation. That was Deborah. The other one wasn't just a simple old housewife.
Come on.
The ones you think that ain't got no power. The ones you think all she do is sit around and just wash the clothes and the dishes and see after the children. Oh no, she was a strong woman of God. Uh-huh. She was. And the both of them came from different walks of life, but they both were used. The facts in this story here, we're talking about judges in this book. There were some facts in this story. There was sin, there was judgment, there was war, there was faith, and there was victory. I just want you to see how God used this courageous, faithful woman to deliver his people from bondage and oppression. I want you to see that God still is using women in his glory this very day. That means you to see that. Y'all don't like to help me. See, y'all too quiet. I thought God came to deliver us from something. I thought he said, did he not say, get the job done? These men.
Come on.
Oh, I didn't say be head over the man. I said help the man. I didn't say run the house.
Come on.
I didn't say be all in control of everything.
Come on now.
I said help him. He you your helpmates.
That's right.
Help the man. Don't talk about it. Don't put him down.
Come on now.
He gonna make mistakes.
Yeah.
You making them.
Quiet.
So I said, get the job done. That's why we here. This is more than just about Deborah. This is about you. Who you think God sent me here for you? I don't think he made no mistake because I haven't ate in about 5 days. I haven't had no sleep. So I think this is the word from God when he said, I thought I was nervous, but now, Lord Jesus, yes, Lord.
want to explain a little bit more to you that over in verses 1, and I gotta kind of tell you what was going on at this time and in the season. See, there was a man, his name was Ehud. He delivered Israel from Eglon and the Moabites. The land had rest for over 80 years of war.
Right.
That's over in Judges 3 and 30, just in case you want to go check it out. As long as Ehud lived, I just want to tell y'all, as long as this man lived and judged the nation, the people followed God and served him. When Ehud passed away, guess what the people did? They returned back to their sinful ways.
All right.
Over in Judges 5 and 8, he said, I told you, again, did evil, they did evil again in the sight of God, of the Lord. They chose new gods. That's what they did. The people of Israel turned their backs on God of their salvation and followed these little gods of the Canaanites.
Oh my God.
There was a spiritual void in their lives.
Amen.
And they walked away from the Lord. They no longer had Ehud to direct them, to guide them, or to even tell them the truth. They just wanted. See, God said somebody's wondering.
Come on.
You're lost.
Why
do you want to walk away from your father? He said, I was the God of your salvation. You were supposed to follow me, not me. Yeah. See, the children of Israel, through time, we often do that in the church. We see it all the time. People, they, you know, follow God for a while, and then they spiritual void come in their life, stuff happens, and they turn away from God, and then they seek their own way. But over in Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all of thy ways, what he say? Acknowledge him, and he shall do what? Come on. That's all I want you to remember.
All right.
He wants you not to scatter just because something happens. I told you, he said, get the job done.
All right.
Just get the job done.
All right.
That's what he said.
Amen.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Thank you.
Yes. Oh, Israel, he said, be watchful. Sometimes the old enemies from your past, they'll rise up when you least expect
them.
Oh, old bread of heaven. Sometimes he'll rise up. When you least expect that old joker. Here he comes. Oh, shit. He coming. That sin that you thought you conquered.
Come on.
You thought you conquered that. Yeah, you did. That's why you quiet on me. You thought you conquered it. Oh, but he said it will defeat you if you give it an opportunity. Somebody gave that old joker an opportunity. I thought we said that we was going to get the job done. He bought you with his blood. Now he done sold them.
Now,
bring the word.
Which means to turn over. That's what he said. When he sold them, it means to just turn it over or give up. In other words, God abandoned them to the life they chose for themselves.
All right.
They chose.
Well. They chose it. Y'all listen to my words real clear. They chose
all right.
this.
All right.
They chose it. Uh-huh. That's not the plan God had for your life.
Right.
Somebody done chose some things.
All right.
Oh.
All right.
Uh-oh. Uh-huh.
All right.
Yeah, 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 God. Yeah, God. I hear you, Jesus. I hear you. Okay. They had to pay the price for their rebellious spirit.
All right.
That's over in Judges 5, just in case you want to check it out. 6 and 7. It says that they were literally driven from their highways and their homes.
Come on.
So when you sin, you mess up, you repent, you try to get it right, there is going to be some chastisement.
All right.
Come on.
All right.
Right.
Sure. Come on now.
There is still a high price to pay for disobedience. I'm just going to give you this. When you choose our way, when we choose our ways over his ways, when we choose to follow other gods instead of him, we can expect his displeasure.
Well.
We can expect him to send some chastisement.
Yes.
Oh, it's going to happen.
Yeah.
It surely is.
Yeah.
He said, get the job done.
Yes.
But you chose to do what you want to do. Oh, yeah, yeah. They're over in verse 3. I'm still breaking it down. So y'all tell me if y'all getting something. Is you getting something? I want you to be getting something. Because I don't want to be standing up here in Tonya. Because Tonya ain't delivering this. Okay, over in verse 3, I want to tell you a little about that. Israel was oppressed by Jabin and his armies for 20 years. And as far as Israel was concerned, Jabin was undefeatable.
Come on, come on.
Jabin was their king. He possessed a powerful army anchored by 900 chariots of iron. The helpless armies of Israel possessed no weapons. Yeah. He said over in Isaiah, he said, no weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper. I said the helpless armies of Israel possessed no weapons. They had no weapons. They had no weapons. Oh, hallelujah. And they was coming up against this powerful army that had 900 chariots. They conquered. See, they were a conquered, defeated people. They were a people without hope. Talk about it.
All right.
Eventually, let me tell you what they did. Eventually, they came to the place where they were tired of their situation.
Come on.
Yep. Guess what they did? They called on the Lord. They called on the Lord, and he heard them. I just want to know, did you call on the Lord? Oh, did you call on the Lord? See, you will notice that they did not cry out in repentance. They didn't say, Lord, I repent. No. There's a promise.
All right.
Oh, that's what he told me to tell you. Oh, yeah. See, some of y'all think y'all problems ain't got no prosperity to it. But God's trying to take you somewhere in your problem.
Amen.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he said that their problems that they had, they cried out for deliverance from their problems. Israel never seemed to realize that they was already walking with the Lord. They honored his word and his ways and brought his blessings. See, while they was walking with God, God just wanted them to honor him.
That's right.
So that they can receive the blessing.
Yes.
But since they wanted to sin, because I told sick and tired. You know when you get sick and tired, you're going to have to go ahead and call on the Lord. But I told you, in every problem, there's a promise.
Yes.
Oh, my God. Hallelujah. And then the people called on the Lord while they failed to deal with the root of the problem.
Right.
He said they failed to deal with the root of the problem.
Come on.
Let me tell you what it is.
Come on,
sin. Oh, but he said, if you want to be delivered from it, I got to pull it up from the roots.
Yeah.
You done fed that thing.
Come on.
You fed the sin. So that's why it took. He said, if we really want to be delivered from oppressive effects of evil and a harsh whip of chastisement, we must deal honestly with our sins before the Lord. Our goal should not just be to escape.
True that.
Some of y'all didn't want to escape from it.
Yeah. Come on.
I told y'all every problem has a promise. Your problem got a promise. You just got to speak that thing. Come on. But I know this problem and situation that I'm going through, there's a problem. Oh, it's got to be an end. He says, I'm Alpha and Omega.
Yeah.
That's what he says. So it's got to be an end. If there's a beginning, it's an end.
Yes.
Oh, yes, it is. That's what my mama said. She sure told me that. She told me that before she left this world. She sure did. I love my mama too. I miss her. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah, she helping me this morning. Go on, family. Help me, Jesus. Help me out.
All right.
Go on, show up. Yeah. She preached many sermons to them 14 babies. Yeah. Y'all know I'm number 14. I have 10. I'm the last one. Yeah. It's something about that baby. Strong. I don't know what's wrong with it. Hallelujah. He said our goal should not just to be escape our problems. Our goal should be to be found pleasing to the Lord.
Yeah.
Our goal should be trying to please God.
Yeah.
God told me to tell you to focus on pleasing Him.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
Don't focus on the problem.
All right.
Don't focus on how bad it's been all week. All
right.
Don't focus on you don't have no money in the bank.
Yeah. Right.
Don't focus on them bills. You got a pile of due. Don't focus on it. Don't focus on it. Get over it. Don't focus on it. He said, get the job done. Yeah, I got to keep reminding y'all, get the job done. Don't focus on it. It ain't that serious. Your soul and salvation is more serious than that situation. It's more important.
Amen.
Oh, yeah. See, somebody done forget. Oh, how important it is. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, if we could learn to seek the Lord's will above all things, we could be spared a lot of hardship. And we could be spared a lot of hardships we are forced to face in this life.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Okay, now we're going to fast forward a little bit. We're going to fast forward, and here we're going to focus on Deborah and how she was going to get the job done. Okay, in verse 4-5, her position, the Bible says that it was very clear that Deborah was both a prophetess and a judge. Her name means bee, a spirited, fiery woman. A bee is small, hardly worth noticing, but it can give a nasty sting when it wants to. Over in the commentary of Matthew Henry, he said that her very name suggests the works of the bee. Industrious.
Come on. Mm-hmm. Sharp.
Come on.
Perception.
Amen.
Discernment. Great in usefulness.
Yes.
Sweet to her friends, but sharp to her enemies.
Come on.
Oh, yeah, That's never funny.
All right.
Yeah. Is that not you?
All right.
Oh, y'all done got quiet.
Come on.
Y'all, come on now.
Come on.
Don't get quiet now. The word prophecy suggests that she received the direct revelation from the Lord and shared that word with his people.
Amen.
That was not the only prophetess that was mentioned in this Bible.
Right.
There was others. There was Mary. Mm-hmm. There was Hannah. There was Anna. And there was the four daughters of Philip.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah.
There is no contradiction between this fact that the fact that God calls men. That's all in 2 Timothy. God laid his hand on these women and poured his truth through them in an age when there was not even a complete Bible.
Come on.
I just had to tell y'all.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. See, the Bible is complete now, so you can go ahead and get the job done. She worked when the Bible was incomplete.
Right.
What I hear is, I stand here to tell y'all, here it is.
It's complete.
So you can get the job done. Yes, you can. The word judge says, let us know that she settled disputes. That's what she was doing, y'all. When she was talking to the people, she settled disputes among the people of Israel. They came to her with their problems, and she rendered judgment. Deborah was that leader in that time, y'all. She was the nation leader in those dark days, because believe you me, there was some dark, dark days. You know, her prophecy over in verses 6 and 7, Deborah received a word. She received a word from the Lord, and she calls Barak. That's what she did. She called him. She told him to take 10,000 soldiers and go to war with the enemy. The Lord had already promised to defeat Sisera, the Canaanite general. God promises a great victory.
Yes.
Now, God done told you, I'm going to deliver this in your hand. He said that, get your soldiers. I know it's not enough of them.
Amen.
It's just 10,000.
Right.
He said, but it's okay. Because he said, I promised you.
All right.
Have you not reminded God of his promises?
All right.
Amen. That's it.
You have to remind God of his promises. If he's promised something, he's going to deliver it. She shared that word with Barak. And she finds that Barak seemed to be afraid to follow. He seemed to be afraid to follow that word. And sometimes I know it's scary. Sometimes it's scary. God shares something with you. God give you something. And you got to follow his word. You got to believe the word of the Lord.
Lord, thank you.
But you get scared. You get afraid. We all do. I do. I'm telling y'all, you don't understand. You know what it takes to stand up here.
Amen.
This ain't easy. I'm so glad I ain't bishop.
Amen.
I thank God for my bishop. I got a bishop, y'all. Every time I get up here and say something, I have to say, I got a bishop. And I got a friend.
God bless you.
I can brag. See, I didn't have one.
I don't.
See, somebody didn't wasn't covered. See, when I was walking, I didn't have no covering.
All right.
See, I can thank God for that. Every time I get a chance to give and deliver a word, I can thank God for my bishop and my first lady. I sure do. I thank God for it because I'm covered.
Amen.
See, I'm covered now.
Yes.
I can do it now.
Come all right.
On. I can get the job done.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
I can walk with it now. Some of them volunteer from Benjamin, Ephraim, and Manasseh, and Issachar. And some of the tribes refused to go. Everybody didn't want to go. But those that did go, the ones that did go, they saw that God gave them a great victory.
Come on.
Uh-huh. Yeah. But God, over in verse 15, I got to go back to this. This is how Barak defeated Sisera. Tell it back.
My God.
All right. Come on, God. Let them see. Tells us that God discomfited them because it was more of Sisera's needs than it was of the rain. It was more of them. Sisera's armies was bigger, was greater. They was undefeated. But God tells us that what happened in 15 says that as they fought, God allowed the Kishon River to overflow. It overflowed the base. The iron chariots of Sisera became stuck. See, they had all this equipment, this technology.
Sometimes technology ain't all that.
Them phones don't work out.
Come on.
He had these chariots, the iron chariots of Sisera. They got stuck in the mud. And the soldiers swept away. The chariots swept them away. So that gave Barak's army, his men, an opportunity to save them. So that's how they defeated them. But Sisera, let me tell you what he did. In 17, he got down from the chariot and fled on foot. He traded on foot. But he thought he was getting away. Sometimes, you know, when we think we're getting away from God, we ain't getting away from God. So he gets to the tent of Jael. He goes out. See, that's the other woman. I told y'all them two women. He's putting on me on his feet. This trying. She said, come on in. Her husband was Hebar, the Kenite. And her husband, he was an alliance with King Jabin. He was an alliance with them. He had, I guess, a rapport with them. And so when Sisera, he knew that. So he felt like, okay, it's safe for me to go ahead and go in here because that peg and that hammer, and she oddly walked over over to him. He would lay fast asleep. Remember now, he just got to fight a war, so he's tired. He knocked out. He ain't heard nothing. He's born. He in a third level dream. Ain't no trouble dream. Yeah, he ain't no trouble. I mean, he's so loud. Ain't nobody in the house gonna get no sleep. Come on. And while he wasn't sleeping, guess what she did? She just got that peg and that hammer, and she drove it right through his temple.
My God.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
He died.
Yes, he did.
But see, y'all forget. Barak was still in pursuit looking for Sisera. He was looking for him.
Come on.
So what he did was when Jael saw Barak coming, she said, come here. Amen. She said, come here. Let me show you, man. Let me show you. I know what you're looking for.
Come on.
I already found it.
Yeah.
So she went in, he went in with her, and she said, lay Sisera in a tent with a peg in his hand. He lay dead.
Yeah.
And on that day, God subdued Jabon the king of Canaan before the Israelites. Don't you know that not only did God kill the Canaanites and Sisera, he killed those gods.
Come on.
That they were serving.
Come on.
Because see, that was how Israelites got into trouble in the first place. So God had to come. Don't you know sometimes God got to come in and kill some
gods?
Yeah. And got to die. And then you don't want God to, because you're talking about the problem. I'm focused on the problem. God said, get the job done, woman. So I can take these things out.
Yeah.
I can't take it out if you don't give it up.
Yeah.
My God. Oh, hallelujah.
Well,
I told you. God said, for you.
Come on.
So I can leave you with this. And I'm almost done.
Amen.
Y'all been so patient. I sure appreciate y'all. But I still want y'all to get the job.
Yeah.
Oh, I began to talk to the Lord, and he said, tell them how to get the job done.
Yeah.
Come on.
He said, build my church.
Yeah.
That's how you get the job done.
All right.
He said, walk in obedience.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
That's how you going to get the job done.
Mm-hmm.
He said, enter into the gates. Into my gates with thanksgiving. Enter into my gates with thanksgiving. And into his courts
with
praise. He said, be thankful unto him. That's one way you want to be. Thou hast been faithful over me, but I make thee rule over me. But you gonna have to answer him. If you're not faithful over me, you don't forget who you serve. Oh my God! Oh, he said, if you answer him, he said, I'll be with you.
Yeah.
He said, hello. Yeah.
this fight, you're gonna have to enter in. Oh, he said, when the interim begins, he said, that's the birthing process. Oh, yeah, he said, when you enter in, that's when the chains are broken. Uh-huh. He said, those chains that you've been holding on for so long.
All right.
Oh, those childhood pains. Oh, those pains that go so back, so far back, you didn't even tell your mama about them. Oh, those are chains he want to break. See, you can't enter in. Oh, yes, Lord. See, I was here yesterday in prayer. I had to enter in. I had to go there so that I can come today. So that I can deliver the message. So I had to enter in. Because God's people is looking for a word.
Come on,
do the work that the primary primary care doctor can't do,
come on.
That the regular RN can't do.
Come on.
She can do, or he can do more for her. He said, so tell her when she go in the ICU room, tell her that I see her.
All right.
you for confirmation of your word, God. Hallelujah. I thank you for the speaker, God. Cover her. Thank you, Lord. The word has gone forth in this place today.
Thank you.
young men and young women. I thank you, God, for a heart towards you. Lord, I thank you for joy. Restore the joy. Shall prosper. Declares the word of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. No weapon formed. I declare over each and every one of you that no weapon formed shall prosper in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. praise and give God the glory. Praise God. What a tremendous word today from Minister Ousley. We are so blessed. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We give God praise. Hallelujah. Get the job done.
Get it done.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. We're so honored. We appreciate you, woman of God, for a tremendous word. I pray that you have received it today. All of us have to be motivated to do what God has called us to do.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The days of excuses are over. The days of blaming others are over. Hallelujah. But we have to do what God has called us to do.
Yes.
We have to honor the assignment that He's placed within our hands.
Yes. Thank the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. So we're so blessed today. Praise God. Praise God. This is our fifth Sunday. We have the fifth Sunday fellowship meal prepared for you to take home with you. Praise God. So we thank God. It's already prepared. We're not going to sit in the fellowship hall this time, but we do have some carryouts for you. Amen. You want to get your carryout and have a seat, that's fine. But it is prepared for you. And so we thank God for you that have come and all of our guests and friends and visitors. Praise God. It's good to see all of you in the house today. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We honor the Lord today. Hallelujah. Can we just sing a little bit? Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. How many know that God has spoken?
God has spoken.
And the church confirms it by saying amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let us confirm that. Let us declare that today before we leave this place. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That God has spoken in this house.
Yes.
We confirm it by saying amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Because there's something about when God speaks, there's not only an affirmation, but there's a confirmation.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. And so we confirm, hallelujah. The Bible says His word shall not return void, but it's going to accomplish every purpose. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And so we thank God today. Hallelujah. Praise God. Come on. Let the church
according to your word, in Christ's name, amen.
Amen. Amen.